Do your patients have diabetic eye disease?
Diabetic eye disease is a group of eye problems that can affect people with diabetes. These conditions include diabetic retinopathy, diabetic maculopathy, cataracts, and glaucoma. Diabetic retinopathy is a condition that occurs due to damage to the blood vessels of the retina. Symptoms of diabetic retinopathy include spots or dark strings floating in the vision, blurred vision, fluctuating vision, dark or empty areas in your vision, and vision loss. Diabetic macular edema is a condition that manifests as retinal thickening caused by the accumulation of intraretinal fluid in the inner and outer plexiform layers. The symptoms of diabetic macular edema include blurry vision, seeing colors that look washed out, spots or dark strings floating in the vision, and double vision. Diabetic macular edema manifests as retinal thickening caused by the accumulation of intraretinal fluid in the inner and outer plexiform layers. The symptoms of cataracts include cloudy or misty vision, blurred vision, spots in your vision, being dazzled by bright lights, seeing a circle of light around lights, and a yellowing of the vision. Glaucoma is a group of eye conditions caused by an abnormally high pressure in eyes resulting in damage to the optic nerve. The symptoms of glaucoma include seeing halos around lights, vision loss, redness in the eye, and eye pain. The risk factors of diabetic eye disease can be unmodifiable or modifiable. Duration of diabetes, type of diabetes, and puberty or pregnancy are unmodifiable risk factors. The modifiable risk factors include hyperglycemia, hypertension, renal function, dyslipidemia, smoking, and anemia. For the diagnosis of diabetic retinopathy and diabetic macular edema, clinical examination is performed followed by an imaging evaluation. The clinical examination consists of a detailed retinal examination, including history, visual acuity measurement, undilated anterior segment slit lamp examination, and dilated retinal examination using slit lamp biomicroscopy. The imaging investigations are essential to establish correlations between structure and function. The investigations used in diagnosis include color fundus photography, red free imaging, ultrasound, optical coherence tomography, fundus fluorescein angiography, and OCT angiography. Recommendations for treatments to reduce the risk of diabetic eye disease include achieving blood glucose targets, blood pressure targets, and lipid targets. The target glycosylated hemoglobin is 7% and should be maintained within the range 6.5 to 7.5%. The target of systolic blood pressure is less than or equal to 130 mm of Hg for those with diabetic retinopathy. In those without diabetic retinopathy or cardiorenal complications, a systolic blood pressure of less than 240 mmHg should be maintained. In those with diabetic macrovascular complications, consider lowering lipids. The purpose of screening is to identify individuals in the latent stage of disease when there is a risk of vision loss. In patients with type 1 diabetes with an onset before puberty, start screening at 10 years of age. Thereafter, annual screening should be done if no or mild signs of retinal pathology are observed. In patients with type 1 diabetes with an onset after puberty, a detailed eye examination should be conducted at diagnosis. If no retinopathy or macular edema is found, start screening 5 years after diagnosis. Thereafter, an annual screening should be conducted if no or mild retinal pathology is observed. Referral criteria for diabetic eye disease includes: a non-urgent referral to ophthalmologist is recommended if no retinopathy or macular edema but reduced vision, or if moderate non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy or non-center involving diabetic macular edema regardless of vision. An urgent referral to ophthalmologist is recommended if more severe retinopathy or if non-center involving diabetic macular edema regardless of vision of other pathologies.